Good morning, children. Last class, I finished it off with thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Thermosetting plastics, I gave few examples of Bakelite, Melamine, Teflon, and I told you that I will be explaining you these examples that for what purpose they are specialized for. So let's start with our first thermosetting plastic, that is Bakelite. Bakelite is a poor conductor of heat and electricity, so it is used to make electric switches. So generally when I speak that Bakelite, it is a poor conductor of heat and electricity, so first thing comes in the mind of children, all plastics are poor conductor of heat and electricity, then why ma'am is giving this particular thing in a specialized way? Because it is only that plastic which can be used to make electric switches, especially switches, electric switches and utensils, handles are made up of special plastic which is known as Bakelite. That is why it is specialized for making electric switches and handles of utensils. Let's come with a versatile plastic. Why the name has been given versatile and why we say that melamine is a versatile plastic. The versatile means it has some special quality. I already told you children, plastics are poor conductor of heat and electricity. But this melamine is a versatile plastic because it can resist fire, can tolerate heat better than other plastic. That is why it can use in kitchenware and fabrics which resist fire. Let me explain you this, children. Fabrics which resist fire. These are the fabrics which are made up of plastics. And which type of plastics? Thermosetting plastics, that is melamine plastic. And who wear this type of fabrics? That is fireman. They wear their uniform. There is a layer on the uniform of this fireman people. When they go to extinguish fire, they wear a uniform which is being made with a layer of melamine and can easily resist fire and can move into the fire and their fabric do not catches fire. And the second one which I'm talking about, that is kitchenware. You would have seen children that your mother basically use a micro oven. Nowadays you have seen maximum people are using micro ovens or oven. And in micro oven, they are using the glass material, which is totally different, and some utensils which are made up of plastics. So the utensils which can resist heat in micro oven and they are made up of plastics, which type of plastic is that? That is melamine. So that is why, what is the name given to melamine? That is, it is a versatile plastic for these two qualities, resist fire and can tolerate heat. Now we come to another type of thermosetting plastic, which is Teflon. Definitely, it should also have some specialized in itself. That is why it has been given a category of thermosetting plastic. What is special about Teflon? Let's see. It is a special plastic on which oil and water does not get stick. So I hope children, one thing comes in your mind when it says oil and water does not get stick. A special plastic. So where can you find that type of layer in any object? Where you put oil and you put water also and they do not stick. That is the non-stick, the word is only used, non-stick cookwares. Nowadays, everywhere, in television, at your homes, or you visit to anyone's house, you will find people are using non-stick cookwares where oil and water do not stick and a slight amount of oil is required to cook food. That is why the utensils made up of Teflon coating, is little bit costly, but the food prepared is very required very less amount of oil, butter, ghee. Because of which coating, children? Teflon coating. And this Teflon coating is what? It's a special type of plastic. Now we will see the advantages and disadvantages of plastic. Children, now let's see the advantages of plastic. There are so many advantages. I gave you few. If you want to add more, you can add more, because there are lots and lots of advantages of plastic, children. Because as you turn around, you will see each and everything is made up of plastics. The first advantage is it is durable. It is very strong and light in weight. It is non-reactive. They are poor conductor of heat and electricity. I have mentioned a point over here. Thus are used in wires. It is easily available. Disadvantages of plastics. Let's see. These are so many advantages we have seen. Now let's come to the disadvantages of plastics. It pollutes the soil, water and air. This I'll teach you in the next topic in my next class. Pollutes the soil, water and air. When burnt, releases harmful gases. You can add over here, when burnt, releases toxic gases. That can be also, you can write in place of harmful. Sometimes animal consume it and choke to death. The plastic could not be swallowed because plastics could not be come into pieces. You cannot make into pieces. That is why it gets choked to animals, esophagus, that is their food pipe, and they come to death. Choke the drainage system also, because microorganism in drains, you will find bacteria is there, microorganisms, small microorganisms are there. They could not break the plastic because they are non-biodegradable material. So if they cannot be broken down, means they are as such as it has been dropped in the drain. So they can choke the drainage system and there can be overflow of water and there can be increase of germs which can spread diseases. So these are the disadvantages. If you want to add more, you can add more disadvantages in this particular points. Now children, one thing which you have to mark in your NCERT book, if you have. If you don't have, I have already given you Bakelite, Melamine, Teflon. But when you study the chapter through book, please mark this which as a very, very important. Page number 38, did you know? Page number 38, did you know? A blue color box is there. I don't know what is the color of the new edition, but a box with a colored box is there that you mark very, very important. And that very important points I am giving you in the attachment. Whatever attachment I'm sending you, that you have to copy down in your classwork copy. And secondly, the last topic in our next class, which I'll continue, that is plastic and environment. If it is so important, how come it pollutes the environment? Thank you, children. Have a nice day and stay safe.